Hello! Right, I'm back. It's Tuesday. Oh, no, it's not Tuesday. It's Monday for a change. Yeah, nice Monday playing some Transport Fever 2 because I've kind of felt like moving some stuff around and making fat cash. I've been stuck in this loading screen for a couple of minutes, so I thought rather than just sticking around with that screen, I thought let's actually get it going. Hopefully this loading screen shouldn't be too much longer. It's now moving, which is a good start. It's good. So I'm starting a new game in 1850. With like all the trains and everything, because it just gives you more options. Like, I'm not too fussed about trying to do something really hardcore. I just want to play around with some trains and buses and planes, although planes are garbage in this game. but yeah, so we're starting off right in the early stages of the transport era. Just because I want to. We're going to be just making some fat cash, hopefully, in theory. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn up the speed because the default speed is so incredibly slow and just unbearable. Is my sound working as it should be? Yep, it is good. It's so unbearably slow, the default speed. So, yeah, I'm going to speed that up. Once we eventually get through this loading screen, that is... Where I'm playing on a deserty map with a bunch of water turned up to the max and a few other settings played with. I'm not looking to do a really hardcore game, so it's not on hard mode. I don't know what difficulty it's on, I didn't check. But anyway, here we are, we're loading in. I'm not 100% certain about the music, but if the music's going to be allowed, but whatever, who cares. When we eventually load in, the screen is very dark. It's not 100% dark. From what I can see, there's a slight outline of the loading screen still there. Is it going to load? That's the question. I think so. It's on a large map, but it's not on a particularly massive map. Oh, here we go. The music's kicked in. This music is genuinely incredible. Right, that needs to be turned down, I think. That's... Oh god, I've put it on soundbox mode. Hang on. Right, we're going to have to go back to the main menu and try that again. Not on soundbox mode. God, all that loading screen for nothing. Right, so... Anyway... This was the map settings that I went with last time. I think I'll make sure I'll put it on medium difficulty because I don't want to play it on easy difficulty necessarily. Let's put it on medium and turn those off because we do want, obviously we don't want to just try. Yeah. Do we care about the vehicles? Environment, dry. I don't know. Or should we just pick... Maybe we'll just pick a vehicle set and don't go with custom settings. Just go in straight from 1850, medium difficulty, and just hit start. European trains. As I'm from Europe, that makes sense. I'm going to turn down the volume settings while we're loading because the music is super loud. It's such great music though. The music is fantastic. My game is apparently crashing. I don't know if it is actually crashed. The game seems to think that it's crashed. Not getting high hopes that it hasn't crashed. We just need to give it a moment to load. I'm sure it will kick back in a moment. It will sort itself out. It's just doing something, no idea what. It's just kind of getting its brain in gear. We'll have to wait and see. There's gonna literally just be 10 minutes of loading screens, so yeah. Just chilling out, watching a loading screen. That's all this stream is gonna be. It's just gonna be the loading screen stream. Just sitting here watching a nice loading screen tick on by and hopefully just wait for it to load. eventually, at some point. I like this game. It's a fun game. It's nice when it loads. It's kind of like OpenTTD, but brought into the third dimension. I feel like planes are underscaled, and there's not enough sort of late game vehicles. That makes sense. And also, I think trains are just so ridiculous. It gets so ridiculously expensive late game. Like in OpenTTD, you get to a late game, you're earning fucking cash money all the time, and you can just buy trains. Whereas this, every single train is an investment, because every single train is like, can I afford that train? Yeah, no, maybe. I feel like the game has genuinely outright crashed. Okay, give me 2 seconds. Just need to reload the game. Right, let's try this again. Let's try this for the third time to get this game up and running. Right, looking for a game to capture, waiting for that to come up. Now this is a very boring start. Do 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 do. Ba da ba 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 ba. The music's great. I love the music. Right. Generating map. We're doing a very large map. So same settings again. I don't know what the terrain is going to be like, how the terrain is going to affect everything. Just going to have to roll with it. Europe, yes. 1850. Hopefully it won't crash. Let's see. Hopefully this time there'll be zero crashes. I think it was because I turned the volume down a smidge. That's why it crashed. But who knows? We'll have to wait and see. Man. I think that this game needs more late game vehicles. I haven't really looked into the mods particularly, but I think it needs more late game vehicles compared to other, like OpenTTD. There's a lot more kind of vehicles in a smaller time frame. If that makes sense. You start in like 1960 and you got vehicles up to 2015 or something like that, 2020. Whereas this one, you start in 1850 and you've got vehicles up to like 2000. It's like there needs to be more vehicles that are more up to date, more modern, because it only really goes up to like the early 2000s. And that's not really, you know, got some much better vehicles since then. Waiting for the loading screen again. This is Loading Screen Simulator 2020. Dude. God. This music is a jam, isn't it? This, it just is. Do 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 do. Oh man, love this music. Gotta sit here and wait. Oh yeah. So I normally come on sort of on Tuesdays and went on Thursdays, but I wasn't on last week because of World of Warcraft. The new expansion came out on Tuesday, and I was too busy playing that. I was like, I want to play that. And I thought, the problem is I didn't really want to play through it, because I thought, yeah, there's going to be 100,000 people playing through it. I might do a playthrough on an alt, maybe. That might be quite fun. Because I've only done the main storyline. I haven't done all the quests. I haven't done all the kind of lore master stuff, so I might do that. But the thing is, WoW requires such a time investment. Because I booked the whole week off last week, specifically for WoW. Because it requires such a time investment to get up to max level and all that sort of jazz. I'm hoping I don't have to now reload the game because I played on the default settings. I didn't play with custom settings on at all. So, let's see. On a desert map, I've never played on a desert map. I did a session on the island map. That was kind of fun. And I've played a lot on just the default maps. Look at this town. They're just trapped in this canyon. That's That's nice. I like that. Right. Oil is the best way of making cash money in this game. So, I want to whack this up to like 2x speed. Just because, maybe even 4x speed. Because 1x speed is so goddamn slow, it's ridiculous. But when it comes to date progression. The only problem is it'd be nice if you could set that before starting the game because it affects your graphs and stuff. I might turn the music down in game. I don't know how loud it's too loud. Right, so using boats is not going to be feasible for getting that oil to the oil refinery because there's a massive ass cliff in the way. We could certainly maybe use a train. There's two oil refineries really next to right next to each other. Got two oil wells. So that is certainly doable using a train. In fact, that, god damn, that is close, isn't it? That is so close. Oil is probably the best starting resource just for making money early on. I think that's going to have to be the choice, isn't it? Just going to have to be a quick ass train route from one to the other. Is that going to be best? Got money, so that should be all right. Cargo station. I think one of the things I don't think passengers make enough money. I think passengers are under. Undertuned. They're kind of, you really don't get any money from moving passengers around. Like, every passenger train I've ever tried has been at a loss, pretty much. You make loads of money moving cargo around, no problem. The music keeps cutting out, it's a bit weird. Right, for now I'm gonna just do side to side, max speed 120. It looks pretty flat, actually. No, it does go downhill one way, but that's fine. So for now, I'm just going to do backwards and forwards. I don't have a lot of money. I will definitely do a two-way system at some point because I would think that might be beneficial. Oh. Oh, okay, it's good. I was going to say, it would be really silly for me to put this at the refinery end, considering we'd have to go to the refinery and then go back, whereas it makes more sense for me to put it at this end. Right. So, line one, what am I going to call this? Medlar with Wesham. That's a weird name. Okay. Medlar. Oil. One. Nice. Fantastic. Gonna rename that to MWW Oil. It's just called Oil Well. Because Medlar with Wesham is such a long ass name. MWW Oil Refinery. Fantastic. Right, so let's get a train. Is that the only train I've got? That's the only train I can get. How long is this station? It's like 160 meters or something, isn't it? Stupidly long for this. Really didn't need to be this big, but whatever. Yeah, it's 160 meters with the default length. See, look, this train is gonna cost me $1 million. Now, in 1850, $1 million, this would have been, I don't know, how much would $1 million have been in 1850? Like, that would probably be on the more like $1 billion back then. Because even you probably could buy a train for $1,000 back then. Do you want to buy a second one? have the cash. I don't think it's worth buying it just yet. Go away, Tip. How do I hide Tips? You have a camera tool. Interface, force units, blah, 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 blah. Boring. Okay. Enable guide system. No. I don't need Tips. I know what I'm doing. I know how to play this game. I've played it. How many hours? Enough hours. 41 hours. Not bad. Okay, we need to get this sped up. That train is moving super slowly. Come on, train. You don't need to go all the way to the end of the station. No, no, you're going to the middle. Okay, fine. Are you... This thing is going to be filled with oil by the time it gets back. No problems with that. So while we've got that running, let's get the other track. Which direction do you want us to go in? I think is the ultimate question, really. Well, as a Brit, it makes sense. Like, they drive on the left. So that's the way I'm going to do it. Two terrain. They don't need to come out into the thing. So I'm going to put that there. There we go. Right, so we can actually get a second one of these trains. How's it doing finances wise? It is making money. Now it's full of oil, rather than only being slightly full of oil. We're going to need another one of those trains easily. Because this thing has so much oil in it. The boats are, I think, very good for a good start, for starting moving oil, because they can carry so much. Like, a train of the same cost as a boat is more expensive. Same storage, even, as a boat is more expensive. Oh, I suppose you could, in the, for it to be the way I said it the first time, a train with the same price as a boat would have less storage. I think. I don't know. Might not. You know what? This is annoying me. Let's get this going. I basically never build straight roads in this. Just because there's... It just doesn't make sense to make any of the roads straight, does it? It's a bit kind of Red Dead Redemption-y, this, isn't it? What's that? Oh, they're birds. Hello there, birds. Cranes. Ah. Lots of maces around here, aren't there? I think I turned that test setting up a little bit too high. I like the canyons, though. They're pretty cool. I wonder if you can put it, have a boat going through a canyon. Now... That's a very nice place to live, I'm sure. But when people settled towns, they'd obviously want to be near a source of water. Now, they are near a source of water, but only if you were to go straight down. I don't think you would very likely see a town on the top of a fucking mesa or canyon. What is with that ladder? That, if you're using that ladder, you've got a death wish. Seriously. This is... Who on earth decided that would be a good place to put a ladder? It's barely on the edge of that cliff. It's like, if you fall off, you are dead. You're going right down that canyon. Man, whoever's using that ladder is a fucking brave person. Man. How am I doing? I'm losing money. At the moment, am I going to be continued losing money? No. My finances are on the positive. I feel like we need to have more carriages. Right. That'll do, because that'll bring us up to mediocre. It keeps us on a mediocre power setting, so that should be fine. And I don't think it's going to be going much slower. Okay, it's going 25 kilometers an hour. So compare it to this one when it goes uphill. See if it's going much slower. It's going like 5 kilometers an hour slower. I think it's worth having the extra. Just because we really need that money coming in. How much did we get from that? See, look at that. Look at the income versus the expenditure on that. Choo-choo! We can definitely get more oil. More trains going if we wanted to. This thing could easily supply more trains, I think. We'll see. Obviously, it's going to cost us a lot to get another one of these trains. How much do we get for each one? Is that like 100 grand? Is that it? It's already been 8 years. The problem with the ridiculously high timescale is that it takes them like a month to go from there to here. And our graphs and our charts don't look very good, do they? Because we're earning it slowly. I'm assuming maintenance is at a set time in the game, and a scale based on that time. Not got nothing to do with this, I'm assuming. $179, is that it? Is that really all I get from that oil? God, this game is really, like, tuned to be hard to earn money in. I'm not even 100% certain I'm earning money at the moment. That's the thing. Right. Well, let's build down our headquarters. Where do you want them to be? Let's put them in Medlar with Wesham, or whatever it's called. No idea what that means or why it's named that. My money is going up. I'm now 1.1 million. It might be a good idea to use trucks for other things, because they have a lower cost, lower maintenance cost. Not these. I really felt these trains are earning fucking nothing. I mean, they are nicely, if you look over the course of the 3 years, they are earning money. And we are, our money is going up, but it's kind of going up and down, up and down, up and down. And we do have a positive, which is good. Maybe we just need a faster train. These trains are really rubbish. Maybe we need a better train. Hmm. Well, I think we'll set up a little route for the, for like a ground transport setup over here, and see if that's any better, and see if that earns money. $71,000 is quite a lot of money. Truck station, here we go. Do-do-do. And another truck station. Let's try and get it close. Obviously, the smaller the distance they have to travel, the better. Ghoul Annex and Ghoul South. So we want to call this, what is this? This is Ghoul Oil Well. And this is Ghoul Oil Refinery. Refinery, that's what we want. Ghoul Oil Refinery, fantastic. Right, so set up a line. I've already done that because I'm smart. Ghoul Oil 1, and then we just need to get some horse-drawn carriages. Like $23,000 each, maybe we'll buy like 5. That's nowhere near enough to have a constant supply chain, but we'll see how much money they bring in, because they might bring in enough to kind of sustain themselves. No! There's no point in you going all the way to the oil refinery. You know, we just pause this. There we go. Right, now they're going to be going to the oil well instead. Maybe we'll buy more if we if they actually do earn money. Thank God they are in and out super fast, aren't they? What are you waiting for? You're holding up a massive queue. Like, literally, you're full in an instant. Just move. Are they waiting for the... Can increase the length? Really? Oh. Did not realize that was a thing you could do. Okay, that might be something to do later on if we can. Does that mean we can... Obviously we can store more, but does that mean we can load 2 at once? Street access, station entrance. What we could do is we can customize it to have it in and out. So what's that? Is that like a... It must be a cargo drop-off, I assume. We're earning money. These things might just turn a profit. If they all turn a profit, then that would be fantastic. Currently one of them isn't, but I assume it hasn't arrived yet? Yeah. I mean, they only hold 4 barrels of oil. This one train is doing most of the heavy lifting in terms of cash. But I think it's just because of the time difference, the time delay between the two of them. So, let's see, is this going to earn more? Because if this earns money, even if it's like $2,000 or whatever in the time, I don't know, I think it's going to get down to like $1,500. Do 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 do. Construction not possible. Too much slope. What? They're horses. Oh, I upgraded with the tram track. I did it. That's not what I wanted to do. This is a really poorly organized tram station. Not tram station, whatever it is, the cargo wagon station. They are earning money. Which are you? See, that one's now an 8. So, more of them? I think more of them. Oh, we can get it holds 5, and it's only a little bit more expensive. Maybe we get like 10 more. That would be really busy. Oh, they're all going for the other place first. I really don't think that needs to be there, because it was fine as it was. They weren't getting too delayed. I need to change these, get all of these. Turn them around. They'll be fine. They'll sort themselves out, won't they? They'll get there eventually. I'll have a little bit of a loss on that money front for a little bit, but it'll be fine. Just hoping this may we have more than enough cargo for it to be not to be a problem. I think the more we add, the more it stores. So. It might be worth getting another train. We'll have to have a look at the... Yeah, I think we could. But would that actually speed up the process? That's the question. I'm not 100% certain that it would. Oh man, I love watching trains and all this jazz. Currently 1873. We're gonna fly through the years. We're gonna get to like the 1900s super fast. If you're playing on default speed, it takes you like 2 hours to get to, even on full speed, to get to 1900. It's ridiculously slow. Ooh, we've got a full one of the new ones. Gaul is another town. Look at these. Look at these houses. Look at how precarious they are. Like, they are. They obviously the placement of the buildings kind of affected the terrain a little bit to make these very steep edges. Why would you even want to live there? I mean, the view is fantastic. But if someone came and robbed your house, it would be super easy for them to just walk through and throw you out the window at the back. And they would be like, oh, yeah, all the evidence is hidden. Especially in this day and age of 1875, it's pretty... I don't know how lawless it is, but I don't think I'd want to... I would not want to live on the edge of a canyon like this. Just, like, What if you accidentally dropped something out the window? It'd be gone forever. And not only that, you got like this massive step up onto the pavement. Why? Oh man. Interesting choice of place to live, but. Do 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 do. Do 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 do. Turn it down a smidge more. I don't know how loud it is, but it's a farm. Yeah. We can get a farm up and running. If we could do. We could get some of this going. Probably with, again, with, can you do tram depots? You can. Would that be more effective? I kind of want to try it out. I've got cash. I've got a little bit of cash to burn. Right, so we've got a tram track. Can I build a road with a tram track on it? God, the music keeps cutting in and out a little bit. It's a bit weird. Right. If trams are faster than trucks, or whatever they're called, horse-drawn carriages, Ghoul Central to Walton on Thames Halt. So this is Ghoul Farm, isn't it? Really? And this is a Ghoul food. Walton-on-Thames food. I'm assuming I can... Ah, okay. I don't have any cargo trams. That seems a bit silly. Oh, well. The music keeps cutting in and out. It's a bit weird. Maybe what I could do is I can... I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to have... Where's the biggest town? The music is really struggling. Filey is the biggest town. Oh, they've just added a road. I'm going to finish that road off for you just because of convenience. Right. Best places for a tram track. There. Right through the city centre. And then we just need a tram building up here somewhere. Let's just stick it right at the end. Because fuck it, why not? A little loop of tram there. I'm assuming it'll be fine. It'll sort itself out. Right, there we go. Yeah, that'll do for now. There's enough tram stops there. That covers basically the whole town. Probably a little bit excessive. So, from Victoria Street to New Street. What side of the road is New Street on? To Manor Road, to Church Street, High Street. Is that all the stops? Yeah. So what's this town called? I can't remember what it's called. Filey. Tranlike. Fantastic. And there was also another stop. Turn back to New Street. Fantastic. That looks great. I'm gonna get one. Just gonna get one. Fuck it. Why not? Filey train line. Tram line. Away it goes. Meow. Oh, I love the little trams. I've never really built a tram line in this game. We'll see how this does. It's probably not going to earn any money at all. But it's kind of cool. And it's kind of neat. Move, horse. Out the way. Move faster. There we go, there it goes. There we go. It's fine, it's working fine. It looks great. Along it goes. Oh, it's got passengers, look. Oh, this place is busy. I should probably put a stop there, I feel like. So New Street. Church Road. So we'll see how the tram does. It's probably not going to... Actually, it does appear to be earning money. I would be very surprised if it actually earned any money in the long run. I would be very surprised. But we'll see. We'll have to wait and see, won't we? It could be fine. But there it goes. Our little tram is on its way. Oh, we've unlocked a boat. It's now 1885. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. How's our trains doing? These trains are... doing fine. They're still bringing in money. Do you think it's time to upgrade them? We might be able to upgrade them for something a bit better. Edit slip. Vehicle. Let's replace the vehicle. We could replace it with maybe something like this. Go a lot faster, but it requires a lot of money. It's expensive. But we could massively increase its storage capacity to like 70. We'll see. We'll see how that goes. It could be fantastic, but we'll see. It could make me go bankrupt. Who knows? So what about my little oil trucks? Oil horses. Is there anything that's really losing money? No, not at the moment. Everything looks fine. Oop, don't want to pause it. Stadtbahn Halle. Is that a tram? Stadtbahn. I think that's like town. Given the name is... has the word town in it in German, I assume that it's fine. Oh, there's Filey. God, that one has a lot of people trying to move around, doesn't it? Via Church Road. I think we're going to need another tram. It's only a little bit more expensive. Oh, it's electric. I'm going to make it electric. I'm going to have to pay for electric trams. Not too bad. And I'm going to need to invest in it at some point anyway. Away it goes! Oh, look at that. Fantastic. Where's my other tram? There it is. I'm going to replace this one with an electric one. Fantastic. Away it goes. Look at those trams. They're cool. I like the trams. Hopefully that'll help the town grow. Maybe. Will it? Because the town is kind of like a center of technological wonder. You know, got a tram. Look at that. Fancy. Fancy ass town. Fancy pants. Although I have to admit, the catenaries are not the prettiest things in the world. What the hell is going on with this spidery mess going on here? I suppose it's just where the lines are kind of intersecting a little bit, isn't it? Oh, my game is frozen. Oh, we've got a new train. That's an expensive ass train. Looks nice, but it's expensive as fuck. Oh. Kanstadt, double T. Sounds German. Yeah, so you definitely want the tram stops around here. It's the center of the town, isn't it? The hustle and bustle. And this is sort of like the suburby area. So you can get up in the morning, ride your tram to work. What, living the lifestyle, these people now. I mean, if you want to get over here, you may have to come all the way around, but that's fine. Maybe we could add another tram line that's the anti-clockwise. No, because the trams are on the wrong side. The stations are on the wrong side. I'd have to add new stations. I could do that, though. Might do that. Let's give that a go. Might be fun. There's already one. There's already two there anyway, so who cares? Would it work going anti-clockwise? It would go this way, wouldn't it? Cross along here. Through there, up there, along there, and then to there. Yeah. So add a new line. A Filey tram line. Ooh. So click on stations to add. So we're going. So let's start here, makes sense. So click on that one because that's where it's starting. Into there. Then to that one. Although it won't be going that way because there's no there's no track there, but yeah. It's got the spirit. Back to High Street. Nice. We'll see how that goes. It'll be interesting to see. Okay, it does correct the line for the tram. Oh, there it goes. Zooming along now. Town does appear to be growing. A little bit. Very slightly. It's much harder to grow towns in this game. Towns don't just grow naturally. They grow if they've got certain things like transport to other places or like facilities and stuff like that. I just wish passengers paid more, or things like trains were just a little bit cheaper because they are really expensive. the amount of money you get from passengers. You just don't get any money. You earn a little bit, but not enough to really kind of rely on it. We could set up a little train line over to Arlesley. Would it be? I suppose if we were going to go this way, we'd go through this tiny little tunnel here because it's the narrowest, and then bring it along over to Snodland, which is a really great name for a town. Got Oaken Gates over there. Where else can we? The thing is, this town actually is quite a large population. Ghoul is the second biggest. Ghoul is all the way over there. Biggles, Wade. Highly to... That would be quite a good train in terms of people. Would be from Snodland, round through Filey, up to Biggles, Wade, and then to Ghoul. Wouldn't it? Because of just in terms of sheer numbers. That would be hella expensive though. And then we can bring it right back round to Smedic. And do, to be honest, you could do a fucking loop with this. I love the music in this game, it's so good. Are any of my vehicles losing money? No. In fact, some of these trucks are actually doing really well in terms of money. Ghoul oil. Let's replace them all with some more modern. Diesel one. Let's go with that. Let's go faster. Bit of an expense, but they go a little bit faster, and they still hold 5 cargo, but they're hopefully be moving it a little bit faster, so they'll be earning a little bit more money out of it. And they also load it a bit faster as well, so that's hopefully a benefit. It's really close behind, isn't it, that one? I think they kind of wait for other people to move to try. They try and space themselves out a bit so that they're not right behind each other. I mean, it's a little bit annoying. I kind of wish that they would just move, just make it, you know, just move it onwards. But whatever. Wow, that's a lot of things we just unlocked. We've unlocked a bigger train, bigger tank cars, a bigger boat, although there's not really, we can't really do much with boats here anyway. I'm assuming I still haven't unlocked tram cargo. Trams? No. That's a shame. That'd be kind of cool. I'd like to see that. I'd like to see cargo trams. That would be kind of fun and interesting. But anyway. Trams look good. I have got sound on, right? It is working and coming through as it should. Yep, that's all good.
Yep, that's fine.
Right. Ooh, that's a new tram. That's a fancy ass tram. That's a double seater tram. Let's get a fancy ass tram in here. Look at that. Look at how fancy that is. I'm going to replace all the trams with these. In fact, I might even get, I'll get another one of those for that line as well. I spent a bunch of money on trams, but they look cool. They're nice. I like them. They are earning money as well, by the looks of it, mostly. They're not losing any money. It's funny, but how my profit graph keeps sort of like just fluctuating up and down. That must, I've just spent loads of money recently. That's why that's dropped a lot. My value is now above zero, which is fantastic. So is this is earning money, right? Yeah. And it's also, it is actually faster than that train. That's earning, is it earning more? That's the question. No, it's earning less. That's a shame. Well, I'll leave it as it is for now. I won't upgrade the other train for a while. Oh, those little road vehicles are earning their keep. They really are now, aren't they? They're doing a good job. Oh, that was gone up to 300,000. Ooh. So, manage this vehicle. That would cost me 3 million to do that. It's gonna cost me a lot of money. Maybe I won't increase its length particularly just yet. I'll just increase its kind of, I'll improve its engine. The Postbus ET13. Oh, it's now 1905. We're past the 1900s now. Pretty good. That's pretty good. We're going to get way to the 2000s before we've even got like to the 2 million earnings mark. The thing is, I suppose, as you play, as you get more infrastructure down, you'll just start, as long as it's earning its money, your income will just increase. The more you put down, the more income you'll get, in theory. As long as these things are sort of are earning their money, aren't losing money, then you should be fine. You just need to keep growing, I think, is the thing in this game. Growing is important. Right, so we don't really care about a tram depot. Oh, okay, I understand. I bought tram stations. Let's just get rid of that line. Which line is it? That one. Boring. Right. So, let's move some wood around, because that's always a good shout. Moving. There's nothing wrong with moving more things. So the left side is all about, the right side is about collecting, the left side is about delivering, right? What's the benefit? Because these ones are just delivering on the left side. You can't have a tram track. Where was the wood? So I'm thinking we can maybe try and improve this town a bit by getting some of this stuff around. Do, 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 do. I kind of want to know if this, if you can just buy stuff from there and sell it. Without having to stock it. I don't think you can, but I'm interested to find out. So, what's this? This is Filey Machine Parts? Filey Machines. I think you need to fully supply the line for it to actually do anything. I don't think you can only partially supply the line. Which is a bit annoying, really. It'd be nice if you could do that, if you could just do part of the line. So we'll get like one little truck thing going. Just buy one truck. I'm guessing that it's just gonna say no. For some reason there's a tram track. Yeah, there's nothing coming out of that at the moment. So we need to get wood into this. Filey wood. Okay, let's just get a few, let's get a few of these bad boys moving wood around, because that's not a bad shout. And then we can get this over to there. Gonna want to have a little bit of a bypass from the town, because otherwise it's just gonna take forever and be annoying. Buy new planks, fantastic. And then maybe get like two of those going, because we just don't need that many. Oh, I've just changed it. No, I haven't just changed it. Have I been fiddling with that, changing numbers? I've got no idea. Fortunately, it's on studio mode, so it does just change straight away. Right, so. God, that's going to be a process, isn't it? We need to get this, the steel, over to here, but we also need to get coal and iron to the steel, which is doable. I think that's the best way of doing it, really. But this is not making any money. Filing machines, that vehicle, manage vehicle, set line. I'll set you to wood. Fuck it. Go and do wood. You'll have to travel a little while. He's gotta turn around and kind of go somewhere else now. That is fine, that's good. My plank dudes aren't making much money. I think that's because I need more wood trucks. Eight. Let's get like six of these. Right, we've got a lot more of those going now. It's now 1913. Diesel vehicles are going to be start really coming into this now with diesel vehicles, which is fantastic. I don't know how long. I'm a bit worried that I've been playing around with the buttons on my number pad and I've just been muted or something for ages. I don't think I have. I need to remember to, because I've got all the settings for OBS on my numpad. So it's like, oh, press all the, and then I also try and type in numbers. So it's a bit, am I getting it right? I don't know. I don't know. Am I fiddling with stuff? I just keep forgetting and just keep slipping my mind. I'm looking forward to, in 3 weeks' time, after Christmas, I've got like 3 weeks off. So I'm going to do more intense over those 3 weeks, hopefully. Depending on if that's what I'd like to do, because I'm not doing anything during those days, and it'd be great. Because I'd love to have a slightly bigger audience, that'd be fantastic. Oh, no, that's not worked. Okay. Okay, we'll go back to that. That's fine. So, almost all of our vehicles are earning money at the moment, which is fantastic. They're all doing their part, which I love. So, because they want food and they want machines, don't they? So we can get them machines, and unfortunately, it's really annoying how generally towns aren't near the things that they can make. Apart from this particular case where the machines factory is right next to the town, for example, there is a farm and a food processing plant, but the food processing plant is fucking up on top of a goddamn mesa for some reason. I think that would be worth getting set up, actually. 40. That's going to be expensive. 1.8 million? God damn. Right, well, we need to get over to the farm. Don't we? If we're going to be setting up a farm run, we need to get over to the farm. And because it will be about a tenth of the price, I'm going around the mesa, not over it. Would it be? Is that feasible? I mean, it would cost like 2 million. I think I could just take out a loan. Could I? How much am I paying in loan? 16 grand. I'm paying about 50 grand a month, or every few years in loan. To be fair, I don't have to build a road necessarily. There is a road available to me right there. I'm just going to use. It's quite a long distance to travel, but with enough that if you get enough trucks, it really makes no difference. The good thing about trucks compared to trains is that with enough trucks, it makes zero difference the distance, because they will always be coming and going. It can do depending on income, I suppose. I suppose it would make a difference. Oh, we're gonna make a plane! Fantastic. Great, useful. God, that's lagging. Right, let's get that up and running. Let's get up that there. Get that there. God, we're losing money at the moment. But that's just because I'm spending it. I'm spending it faster than I'm making it. Okay, finally. Oh, no, that's not what I wanted. Fortunately, there's no vehicles on that line to be travelling all that way. Finally, food. Good name. Right, then we need a line. It goes from there to there. Filey food delivery service. Service. So, what matters? I mean, as long as they're making more money on each journey, as long as the trucks are making money from delivering the stuff, the only thing is, this is a very long way for them to travel. I'm not sure if they're gonna. It might be. Once I've got a bit more money, I will probably put a tunnel in, like I was going to. But for now, I'll just buy a couple of trucks. It'd be better if I put down a road depot. Rather than bringing them from like fucking 10 miles away. Okay, put down that road depot there. So, all cargo. Can't move food, but it can move that route, so that's fine. Maybe like 5 of them. Right. Away they go. That's a really fancy ass road, isn't it? We're getting up that mesa. This is not something that would have been constructed in the 1920s. This kind of road, I don't think. Like, not around here anyway. Maybe in like a massive city somewhere. But certainly not in the middle of fucking nowhere. It would be nice if cities grew a little bit more organically. Because the thing is, it would be great to get some big roads between some of the towns. Or if there was like, I'll tell you what's great about OpenTDD is the subsidies. If this had subsidies, that'd be great. This game just needs subsidies where the towns will pay for some. They will basically pay you to build a road between two places because it's quite a big expenditure, you know. Or they will, you know, they'll pay you money for use of a road or something like that, where they'll just to kind of give you the benefit of that road. Or even like, if I build the road, I want to put a toll booth on it so that when people drive over it, cars, general traffic, they have to pay me for the use of that road. Oh, I've got, you can make it the Flying Scotsman. That's 6 million. I should be able to buy a Flying Scotsman, but the thing is, just can't. I'm just nowhere near that time in terms of money. Game is lagging a little bit for some reason. At the moment, nothing's losing money, even the food trucks. Although it's not the food delivery service, these are just the food trucks. The slight problem is the only delay is that this station is only sending out a certain number of trucks at a time. Even though they're filling up, they kind of sit there for a few seconds, which is really annoying. It'd be nice if they just left. It'd be really helpful if they just kind of just went on their way rather than hanging around for ages. We are earning money more quickly now. The money is certainly coming in at pace, which is quite nice. I think branching out is a good thing to do in this game, kind of not just sticking with everything, kind of branching out your investments. This is quite a nice supply line, actually. Look at this. We can get oil from here to here, then pick that up from there, deliver it to there, then from there to there. Nice, easy, problem solved. And we can do that all with trucks. new roads. Oh, the roads have been upgraded. They're no longer just like dirt roads. Now they're tarmac roads. Fantastic. Right. So, we want to get a truck station over by the oil. Only really need one, don't we? We do want two here, because we want one for delivery and one for pickup. Perfect. And we want two over here. Again, one for delivery, one for pickup. Right, so let's get this from there to there. What's that? Arlesley. Arlesley. Oil. One. Arlesley. Oil. Two. Stage two. Arlesley. Fuel delivery. Right, so let's get a road depot. Where do we want the road depot? Here we'll be fine. So we kind of want, we're probably going to want a couple, aren't we? We're going to want like 10. I say a couple. 10. We're going to get 10 for the oil. We'll let those go for a little bit. We'll come back to this in a bit and get this set up with some more stuff. We'll let those kind of get the production line running, get some money in, and get them going. I think they're mostly, they're one-to-one ratios, aren't they? Although, isn't it like, for producing oil, it's like two oil to one, I can't remember. I'll have to double check. Let me just double check what the ratios are. Where is the... Let's have a look. Transport fever 2 ratios. Production chains. That's what I was looking for. So crude oil to oil is 2 to 1. The advanced stuff is 1 to 1, generally. But this, the simple to the medium... So, stage 1 to stage 2 is 2 to 1. Stage 2 to stage 3 is 1 to 1. By the looks of it. So, we're going to want another farm. Which we can pull from here, to be honest. This one will do. To get, like, a full throughput, that is. Actually, when we've got wood, I was thinking we could use that wood, but there's wood here. So, we can get that wood into there. No problems. No problemos. But we're going to need another farm up and running, aren't we, at some point. We could probably bring a road quite easily up this little ridge. That'd be quite nice. We're going to need some more oil over here. There's quite a lot of oil around here, to be honest. There's oil there. That could be a massively long tunnel. How much would that tunnel be? Let's have a look. 12 million dollars. Be fair, that's a big ass tunnel. Maybe I could go over the mesa, over the mesa, and then down. Let's have a think. Let's go around. Kind of bring it up. God, we've got loads of new things unlocked. Now 1935. Need to kind of make a bridge. Just raise the terrain. That's no problem. Nice. Look at that. Nice little road up the edge of the cliff. That looks very safe. I'd want to drive up that. I wouldn't. There's like a weird ass crater here. Quite nice. We're going to want to start going down, aren't we? Down we go. That's not bad. That's not a bad price. Look at that. That's a good road. It's very shiny. Right. Let's get another truck station in here. To be honest, a little distance we can make it travel as possible is good. So it's Oz Z. Just call it Oil 3. Fuck it, I can't bother with that. I can't be bothered naming it something fancy. Oh, look, we've got new trucks. 12 cargo. Or 14. Ooh, they are very expensive in comparison to these, though. Holy crap. But they can go much faster. Afford a few. We'll give them a go. We'll see how these do. Why do they have a weird kind of gap in the middle? That's interesting. Interesting design choice by the people who made these trucks, but whatever. And hopefully these diesel cars will have a much better job of getting up and over this fucking mesa than a tiny ass truck would. It's quite a hike for these things. They've got a long way to go. Like, for them, this is like 3 months of constant driving. Need to upgrade that road. Vroom. Here come the bigger trucks. First one's actually about to arrive. That didn't take that long. They are cat. The problem is they are will be being slowed down by the smaller trucks. How much did that make? I suppose the first one wouldn't have made any money because it was empty. Oh god, they don't make any money at all. Those lose money. Those have got really high maintenance costs. And actually, that's another problem with some of the more expensive stuff, is that they have really high maintenance costs. I haven't checked some of the other stuff for ages. Oh, it's all fine. It's all good. These things are all fine. They're all making money. Yeah, I didn't really check what the maintenance cost is. There's just the money earned from some of this stuff is not tuned well against the money it costs to maintain it. Like, that's the problem with trains a lot of the time, is that they're just underpowered. If you're playing on easy mode, then oil is just free money. But this is on normal mode. Or medium difficulty. How much would an airport be? Like, if I were to use a cargo plane, it's like 30 million to even build a fucking runway. I don't think it would have cost that much in 1942 to build a cargo runway. Especially in the middle of nowhere. I'm sure that if this oil company felt the need to, they could probably afford to... Oh, I suppose they have to have like a... Like if you just look at the fucking... I'm pointing at my screen. You can't see me. I'm pointing... If you just look at this fucking mesa, how it's just completely carved out. That's why it costs so much. I mean, if I were to put an airport here, it's only like 4 million. If I were to put it here, it's like 40 million, because you have to get the approach and the takeoff space. If you flattened out this rock, you could totally fit an airport in there, no problem. Might just be a slightly steeper descent. That's fine. How's Filey doing? Filey has grown. Filey's gone up to 308. It was at 290 something, so it certainly has grown. Right, let's get this going. Because it would be good to get another cargo truck. Well, try and get that food production done. Wouldn't it? That would be quite good. Quite a good thing to get up and running. So this is Filey food. Food too. I need a truck from somewhere. It was there, wasn't it? Let's get these. Here we go. Filey food. I'm gonna get some more trucks. Those are so much cheaper than these ones. What the hell? Not massively cheaper. But this is quite considerably cheaper, isn't it? I can buy 5 of these for the price of 2 of these, which is insane. But then this carries quite a lot more cargo. Right. Let's see how they do. Some of these things are losing money. Obviously, these are because they're not, haven't had a chance. One of them is earning money, but I'm assuming that's just because it's just... Oh no, it has got oil in it. It has oil in its cargo space. So where is that one vehicle that's making money? Just arrived. So this one vehicle is a hope that the rest of them will pick up their slack. It only has two in it, though. Maybe I need less. Maybe I'll sell one of these vehicles. I'll pick one that hasn't got anything in it. Because if it only had two in it when it was picking it up, it means it's, the oil is not coming through fast enough. It's not being made fast enough. Yeah, this oil is really slow. Why is it so slow? This thing's at 400 production. This thing, this oil well is at, what's this at? 400 production. It's at full production speed. We'll see how it goes. But I don't think it's fast enough. Maybe we'll get another kind of cargo space. Which one's just arrived? What are you? You're number 46. 47 is arriving now. Forty-five is arriving as well, and it's out of oil. So I'm going to sell number 49 and number 40. They're all full. They're all full now. So they should be. They should start making money. Hopefully, we'll see. At the moment, everything else is making money, no problems. I suppose as we get more of them, we don't need as many. As we get upgraded the vehicles, we don't need as many of them because they hold more cargo. It just isn't making it fast enough. This thing is filled with wood, though. There's no problems with the amount of wood there is here. This thing's not even running at full speed. Not even running at full speed. Yeah. I wonder what the best way. What you kind of really need is you really need to just go, right, you're going to pay me for every log that goes along a conveyor belt between the two places, is what you kind of really would want to do. But it's looking good. I think we need bigger trucks on this line, I think, is probably what we're going to need. Is that will be the solution to this problem. That would cost me 2 million. Is it worth it? Yes. We're going to go for it. We're going to go for it. We're going to spend the money. We're going to really increase that movement of objects, of items to bring us in more cash. Ooh, more planes. Lockheed Super Constellation. Too bad that airplanes are crap. As far as I'm aware, they're pretty crap. So this thing should be running at a slightly better speed now, I think. We'll get this. In fact, we'll get a line set up. We'll get some things going for, over to the fuel. We'll get like two. Two will be fine. More than enough to get the oil. There should be no excess. We should be fine. We should hit that with no problem. I think my game's too quiet, actually. Turn it up a bit. I think that'll be a bit better. I'll have to double check afterwards and find, because there's always that sweet spot. There's always the point where it's like, is that too loud? Is it too quiet? I don't know, unless someone tells me. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. Right. I don't really want to have to. I don't really want my vehicles to have to go a massively long way. I don't want to upgrade. So I'm going to do the really expensive but slightly cheesy strat of just doing that. I'm going to buy one of those for the Filey food delivery service. Only one for now. That's a fancy ass looking bus, isn't it? So I think that, yeah, that basically covers the whole town in terms of food. Most of the town. How are the trams doing? I think the trams were doing fine. Yeah, the second food lot is still kind of struggling. I've got a few vehicles that just aren't making any money at the moment, and I think that's just due to their newness. Obviously, I've only just put that one down. These oil ones are doing okay, but maybe I only need one. No, maybe I think it seems to be doing okay. I think it's doing alright. These ones are not doing anything. What? Where are you? I think part of the problem is when this one gets there. There's just not enough food for it to pick up. It's basically full though. It is basically full. It's not actually full, but pretty much full. It's on 10 out of 11. So maybe it just needs a bit more time. I think maybe that one probably just didn't pick any, was the first one there and it didn't pick anything up or something like that. Maybe there was a reason, there was a good reason for it. So we should see Filey growing now that we've got food being introduced to the city. It's now on 321. That's pretty good. That is pretty good. That's growing as well. Allersley. There's a whole bunch of places. I haven't been over here in ages. How are these trains doing? These trains are doing fine. They're just in the background, just bringing me in money. Like, I just completely forgot about those. Those poor people have just been forgotten about. The people driving those trains have just been doing that year on year for about 100 years now at this point. Every day they get up, they drive the trains backwards and forth, and they've done that every day without fail for 100 years. Those people deserve a fucking medal. Good job, train drivers. I respect you. And you've brought me in. I don't know how much money these guys have brought me in over the years, but I'm sure they've brought me in a large chunk of the money. Over 28 years. The money is, they've always turned a profit as well, pretty much. These guys deserve a medal. But I'm going to leave them there for now. I don't care. Going to forget about them again for a while and have a look at some of this other stuff that's going on over here. So, we can probably do with increasing the number of planks coming out of the plank factory. Of the plank factory making place, plant, whatever it's called. So, we're going to buy a couple more trucks. Maybe like there was two, so maybe three more. Filey planks. I think what we could do might be fun. If we get a bit more money, if we set like just to build an airport, build a couple of airports from like Ghoul to fucking Filey, because they're the two biggest towns, pretty much. Oh, Snodland is the second biggest town after Filey. Filey's up to 350 people. Fucking hell! Wow. 405 people that's going to grow to. That you can certainly see it's grown. Wow, that's some got big ass building on there. They're building some big buildings in Filey. Holy crap. Might be worth getting the trams expanded. That might be a thing I need to do. Nice. The food is working. I don't really. I mean, that will hopefully increase the amount of traffic I get in the trams. Finding planks are losing money, but that's because I've just upgraded them. That's fine. Actually, they're all making money again. They're all now making money. That's fantastic. So we'll get like just one doing Arlesey fuel delivery, because just one will keep it going. We'll kind of get the process running for the for improving the town, because it's the closest town to Filey, and Filey is actually where I should probably put my HQ, just because it's just where everything is at the moment. I'm almost up to 5 million, and I can almost completely pay off my debt. So where do you want to put this? I guess somewhere out here makes sense. It's still a tiny ass little shack. I think it might be worth repaying my debt. It kind of sucks that actually you don't repay it unless you deliberately repay it. You don't seem to just pay it off over time. You have to pay it off at some point. Look at that. And now everything is green. Investments. Ah. I'm guessing you'll never earn money from investments. I don't think. I don't know how that works. Filey's getting big. 426 people now. Holy shit. That's a lot of people. Well, is it people or like buildings? Residents. Okay. Makes sense. And I suppose as it grows, it'll grow faster. Is that how that works? The problem with like, if you build like a bus route inside a town or a tram route, is that as it grows, you then have to modify that tram route to accommodate for that, and it's real pain in the ass. I think I kind of covered my bases a little bit with it though. I kind of got this main area and a couple of main roads and this area over here. I think for now it's okay, but I might have to add another few in at some point. Maybe I should build a tram line from Arlesey to, what's it called, whatever it's called, Filey. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna put trams down all along this road. And I'm going to make a mega tram line between the two cities. Because fuck it, they're like cheap trains. they seem to be quite good. And I think it will just help Arlesey grow. I want a new line from there to probably just like here. Filey, Arlesey, tram. Ooh, that's a fancy ass tram, isn't it? In fact, I can't even see because it went home. Okay, all the trams that I've already got, currently got, aren't good enough. I can't even buy them anymore. But that makes them vintage. It's going to be a staple of Filey, isn't it? The incredible old-fashioned trams. I think we kind of want a two-lane road. Just because if we're going to have a tram, we're also, it's going to want to have its own kind of dedicated lane. Look at that. Now people can nice and easily get between. We've got a nice big road between the two towns now. Look at that. That's really bringing it into the future, isn't it? Really modern. It's like getting like a fancier bus, isn't it? At the moment, it's not making any money, but hopefully we'll see it make some money once it's been to the two stations. Perhaps we'll just clone that so that we can kind of get some of the, hopefully get some of the traffic from Filey over there, if there is any. Can you turn around? You can turn around. I'm going to make you turn around and go to Filey first, because it'd be good to try and get some of the traffic. Try and get some of the trams going. That's not how trams work, but fine. That's really not how they work, game. I mean, I want to watch this one do the same thing. I assume it's because it couldn't find a route elsewhere, but that's just funny. This one's got 14 people riding on it now. This hopefully should earn loads of money. It'd be really great if it did. I really want to watch this happen again. Come on. Yeah, this is nice. Got a lovely view as you drive along as well. Although the problem is, the traffic in this game is terrible because it just gets stuck behind the tram. Out the way, Mr. Tram! Need bigger roads in the middle of the town. Here we go, here it comes. Is it going to make any money? Again? It did it again. Oh man, that's funny. That's not how trams work. I mean, even the little rope, the route, it does do that though. It does actually turn around there, so... Fantastic. That's brilliant. I love that. It's great. So I don't think they're not going to make crap loads of money, but hopefully they'll make enough money to at least sustain themselves. And it gives Filey a place with destinations and hopefully make even bigger. Oh, let's make this town big. It's up to 5 million. We are earning cash money now because just because we've got so many things happening all the time from so many different places, we've got money coming in from somewhere. Arlesey has really grown. It went from like 70 to 140. It's basically doubled in the last few years because of my investments. So where are we going to build a big ass road to next? I'm thinking Biggleswade is a good place to build a road to. Dumb name for a place, but... Tramtrack Electric. Oh, I won't do it. That's really annoying. Actually, it doesn't need to be that way, does it? It kind of wants to come this way. Doesn't need to be a tram there. Tram with a tunnel. This is, I don't know how effective this is, oh, wrong kind of road. How effective this is going to be, but we'll have to see. That's an expensive tunnel. But the nice thing is it will connect up the towns very nicely. Which is what I'm trying to do, really. It's a lot of money to spend, but I think it'd be worth it. I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to kind of set this up to be more like a bypass. And then I'm going to upgrade that road. Put tram tracks. If I were to upgrade it to a two, it would actually, that might be beneficial to do in the middle of Filey. Upgrade some of these roads. That's going to be too much money. Don't have that kind of money. Okay, that's fine. So we'll get a... God, we've just spent a shitload of money. I'm sure it'll be fine. It'll work itself out, won't it? So what's this? This is... Filey, Biggles Wade, I think it was. Was that Biggles Wade? I can't remember what that town was called. Biggles Wade. It was called Biggles Wade. Okay, great name. Filey, Biggles Wade line. So we're gonna have to wait for some cash to come in. Actually, I think we've already got enough cash. That's fine. We'll just buy another one of these. In fact, we'll buy a second one just because. Why not? And I'm assuming you're going to Queensway first. I'm going to turn you around so that we get a bit of the traffic going straight away, because it's getting quite a long journey to Biggles Wade. I don't think trams are the most effective way of doing long distance travel, but they work, so fuck it, why not? That junction looks horrible to deal with. Right, we're going to start seeing some more travel, some more traffic. Hopefully, Filey will grow a bit more. Filey, the target population is 479. This town is just skyrocketed in the past few years. I might slow down the date speed once we get to sort of like 2000 or something, because it's going really fast. I feel like four times is a little bit fast, although actually in the time that I've got, it's doing fine. It's not a problem. So how's this place doing? How's this doing? This has really grown. This was on 73, like 10 years ago. Maybe not 10 years ago. Maybe more like 50 years ago. It's basically doubled in size. Biggles Wade has got... We've got quite a few people queuing up to go over to Filey. Filey is a popular destination. The music in this game is the best music. It's so fantastic. It kind of has that open TTD feel. I mean, I don't know if the music from OpenTTD is from the original game or not. That's all I've known it from. But it's just, there's something so jazzy and chill and nice about this music. It's just so great. Do, do, do. I don't know how loud it is. It might be really loud. It might be really quiet. You might not be able to hear it, but whatever. That's a problem. I'm sure someone let me know. The Filey tramline actually hasn't got many passengers, but... God damn, people want to go to Arlesey, and people want to go to Biggles Wade. That's a great name. Even my Filey trams are making me money. They're making so much more money than I thought they would. Seriously, I thought they'd be making like $1,000, but no, they're making me like 200 grand, and that's incredible. Do-do. I want to get an airport built. I want to build a fucking airport. And I want to build an airport because I want to go up to, like, we'll need to have set up a tram. Is there going to be a problem with noise? Could be a problem with noise, but I kind of want to bring an airport, like an airline, over to Ghoul. Just because it's a long way away, and I think people would rather travel by plane than by, like, fucking tram. I mean, that's probably about, I don't know, like 30 miles or something. I don't think in real life it's not really that far. Like, you would almost be able to see it. It's that close. If it wasn't for the Mesa, you'd basically be able to see it. If you're high up enough. It's probably not much further than the distance between, like, London and... I don't know. I'm trying to think. I don't know anywhere around London. Brighton and Shoreham on the south coast of England is the only kind of reference I can give. That's the sort of distance I'm thinking this is. I'd have no idea. How well are the trucks doing? They're in bad condition. These are vintage trucks now, these guys. I've had these guys, I don't know, for like 200 years almost. It's 1982. We're in the golden age of bad fashion at the moment. And look at this. We've grown. Town has grown. We have some big roads over to Arterley, whatever it's called. Uckfield is over there. Snodland. I think we need a big ass road over to Snodland, I think, is the next port of call. And I think I'm going to use this. The game is having a bit of a hissy fit. I haven't saved. If this crashes, I'm going to lose the game. It feels a bit crashy to me. Too much slope. God damn it. I might save the game quickly. Hello. Filey. Bland. Save. Fantastic. Right. Yeah. Just get that save down. Too much slope. That's not fair. Maybe I can do something about that. I've got an idea. I'm gonna reduce the slope by just increasing the distance. There we go. Problem solved. Fantastic. Yeah, that's not a problem. I'm just converting the roads that are already there into construction. Not possible. Why? Bit random, but okay. Let me just get rid of these roads and that'll probably solve the problem. Yep. Yes, it has. Right. Nearly there. Fantastic. Welcome to Snodland. Oh, we need to put... Didn't put tram tracks on that road. But we have now. Fantastic. So, where's the centre of Snodland? Through here, isn't it? Lovely. Right, so we want a bus tram stop. Fantastic. Then we want to get... It's actually paused. Get a line. Oh, not two lines. In fact, let's start over in Filey, because go with Filey main tram station. This town is going to get super busy and it's going to be really hard to navigate. Filey Snodlin Blime. Let me just get a couple of these bad boys. Two. Maybe we... I wonder if we can afford to get the bigger... 2 million! Jesus Christ. Well, we can get some of it upgraded into a bigger, slightly bigger road, just because it's just going to cause so much traffic problems. So many traffic problems, not much. So many traffic problems otherwise. $900,000 to upgrade that road. Jesus Christ, that's expensive. Right, I'll give it another 15 more minutes because that'll bring me to 10 o'clock. Is that a new tram? It goes 70 miles an hour. That's expensive though. That one is very expensive. So at the moment everything's making money apart from these two, which aren't losing too much, but they're losing a little bit. Let's turn you around because I forgot to turn one of them around. Did I? There's no passengers in it, so I must. So I don't know. I'll turn it around anyway. Nice. We have a big road. So also, it means that cars can get over there as well. That's what a hell of a journey to take by tram, though, isn't it? I hope that they are charging these people. Oh my god, I can sit in. I can ride the tram. To some degree, I can kind of be on the tram. I've never tried this before. I didn't even know that button existed. Look at us go. Just zooming along. Don't care about traffic lights. That's not a problem for us. We're in a tram, bitch. Traffic lights wait for us, which is the good thing about the trams. Look at the view. Oh, you can see Snodland. Is that Snodland? I don't think that's Snodland, is it? Headed for Mill Road. Around the corner. It's a bit of an oddly sharp corner, that, isn't it? We are being overtaken by a minivan. That's fine. These things, it'd be good to get slightly faster ones. Maybe I'll upgrade to the slightly faster ones at some point. That is Snodland. This is quite pretty, isn't it, really? This game is very pretty. Like, it's not the best game in the world. Like, there are certainly some things that I think would be better, but it is a very pretty game. Oh, what an asshole! That guy in the car! Did you see that guy? He just pulled out in front of the tram! Like, the tram was coming along. He didn't even think to give way. He just delayed the tram because that thoughtless asshole pulled in front of me. Seriously, that is just terrible driving. He should not have his license. What a douchebag. Anyway, the people in this game are terrible drivers. They are literally the worst. They just don't understand how lanes work half the time. My game is frozen. My game is lagging. Am I about to crash? I kind of feel like it. How about we manage to pick up 18 people? Heading for Church Road. This is just chill, isn't it? This is just pretty chill. Sitting back, enjoying the view. I still think a train would be a benefit. Oh my god, there's a deer on the road. Fortunately, it wasn't in the way. My game is lagging a little bit now for some reason. It's having a bit of trouble. It's kind of struggling. Don't know why. I'm just going to sit and enjoy the view for a few more minutes. Oh, there's the other one. Bye-bye, tram. We must have sort of passed at the midway section. They're not turning because we need to go around that a little bit, don't we? That's a very steep little hill there. Now we've got the great bit. We've got to climb this little hill. Oh, you get a great view, don't you? Ah, oh, look at the view. You get to see out, look out over the mountainside, over all the mesas in the distance. Okay. You don't quite get a good sense of scale when you're kind of just flying around on the normal camera mode as you do when you're actually driving around in a tram. Just not quite the same, is it? Oh god, there we go. My phone is just making nails? Noise. I was just a bit worried there that there was no sound coming out, and I just spent 2 hours just sitting here talking to myself, which I kind of have anyway, but you know what I mean. There's this really slow truck. Out the way, truck! This road is getting quite busy, actually, between Ardsley and fucking Filey. There's quite a lot of traffic on it now. Traffic's gonna start picking up. It's probably been about 20 years since I started this little road trip. Oh god, I wonder how long it has been. What was the date when I entered this? There's Filey, we're approaching Filey. Very 70s car there. I assume it's probably about like, I'm gonna guess it's 1995 when I come out of this in a minute. Once we get to Church Road in the middle of Filey, I'm going to guess that it's going to be about 1995. Here we are, we're in the middle of Filey. God, that's a busy station. 1993. Holy shit, that's why we were lagging. Got a whole bunch of new things unlocked. That's pretty cool. And we're on 7 big ones as well in terms of money. Like I said, we're earning fat cash by moving things around. That's people, wood, oil, all sorts of things. So did that actually make money? It fucking did. They are making money. They are actually making money somehow. That one is not. That one's not making any money. But it's only one vehicle of like 30 that's not making any money, and it's losing negligible amounts compared to what everything else is making at the moment. So can't complain too much. Let's get down an airport if we can. How much can we get it down to? What's the... That's Ardsley. Don't want to be near Ardsley. Problem is, if it's a little bit too close, then it will detract from the town. That will do. We're going to need to put a tram stop there. If anything, that's where a tram stop needs to go. Right, so I need to get Filey tram line. Church Street at station. Oh, I need to make that actually a tram street. And the purple one from High Street. There we go. Fantastic. Now we just need to wait for a little bit of money to... how much is it to buy a vehicle? Oh, it's a small one. I need to buy a big one if I'm going to get a big plane. How much is that going to cost me? God, if it actually fucking works. 16 big ones. Ouch. Can't afford that. That's going to have to be a no-go. There, I've broken the terrain. Great. Funky. We've got buses. We've got, I've unlocked a new bus. I don't really care. Anyway, I think that's going to have to do it for me today. It's been fun. I've enjoyed playing this. We've done a good job. We're up to 1997. So from 18, we've done like 150 years almost. It'll be 150 years in like 3 years time. So 147 years. Pretty good. We've gone through, I mean, we put on the maximum speed so we get through it much faster because it's really tedious otherwise. Like, you never unlock anything new and it takes forever to get to the newer stuff. But anyway, it's been fun. I'll be back on Thursday this week. I might play some more Red Dead because I was enjoying playing Red Dead, and that, so I'll probably play more of that. It's been fun. So thanks for sticking around. You can obviously follow me on here, follow me on Twitter, follow me on YouTube and all that jazz. It's all in the panels and about and that sort of thing. So it has been fun. Appreciate you sticking around, and I'll be back on Thursday with some Red Dead, I think, I assume. Who knows? I might decide I don't want to play Red Dead, I want to play something else. But it's been fun. I'm going to save this before I'm not sure if I'll come back to this. Even if I did, I may not be back to this save, because I'm kind of, at this point, it's kind of just going on and doing, building bigger things. So, I don't know. But thanks for sticking around, and I'll be back on Thursday. Bye! Let's find the exit button now, whatever it is. No. 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 Have I not got that on the thing? Hang on. Right. There we go. Right. Bye! See you next time.